Hello friends, welcome to this December module 4 for CLAT, Current Affairs. Let me start with few points. Number 1, the WHO declared Gabon as in country, now that country is polio-free country because lack of new reported or suspected cases in this Central African country is not available. However, remember, there are 2 cases each were reported from Afghanistan and Pakistan, and therefore they are not polio free country. Polio is a highly infectious viral disease. It is coming through virus, which mainly affects young children, and that can result into permanent paralysis. So there is no cure, but it is prevented through immunization. So this is WHO declared Gabon. So where is this Gabon? Gabon is in Africa. In a Central Africa, this is Gabon, okay? This is Gabon, you can say, surrounded by Cameroon, Equatorial Guinea and Congo, okay? Remember that. Coming to issue number 2, Beijing 2022 Organizing Committee unveiled their official emblem of Olympic as well as Para-Olympic Winter Game. So, this is Para-Olympic Winter Game and this is Olympic. 2022 Olympic ho raha hai bhaiya Beijing mein. So this emblem of Olympic and Paralympic winter games have been named as Winter Dream and Flight respectively. The emblem launching ceremony was held at National Aquatic Center, which is Water Cube. Okay, China ne bahut acha Water Cube bana ke rakha hai wahan pe, ye ho raha hai. Coming to issue number 3, a loan agreement and a guarantee agreement for providing additional funding of 20 million euro was signed for Pare hydroelectric power plant under Indo-German bilateral development cooperation. India or Germany? Bhai, Germany ki taraf se ek loan agreement sign hua hai, which is NIPCO. NIPCO ki taraf se skariban, you can say 20 million euro ka, you can say, funding milega. So where is this Pare? Pare is basically a district in, you can say, Arunachal Pradesh, which is known as Papam Pare. Okay, so yaad rakhega ye. Coming to issue number 4, a financing agreement between India and the financing arm of World Bank called IDA. IDA credit has given a financing support of several $125 million for a project of India which is called Strive. So aapko yahan pe yaad kya rakhna hai bhai, world bank ke andar total 5 bodies hai, usme se one of the body is IDA, that is Industrial Development Agency, okay, and there they have given this $125 million ka funding. That's a point number 1 to be remembered. Point number 2 is a full form of Strive. So that is a skills strengthening for industrial value enhancement. So this was signed by Government of India and World Bank. So ye yaad rakhega. Coming to issue number 5, Bollywood actor called Salman Khan, he has been ranked at number 1 on the 6th Forbes India celebrity ka list. So India celebrity mein 100 list nikala gaya, jahan pe number 1 is Salman Khan, number 2 is Shah Rukh Khan, and number 3 is Virat Kohli. Okay, so 2017 Forbes India Celebrity 100 list ranking are based on the estimates of entertainment related earnings of celebrity. So the period in consideration was October 1 to September 30, 2017. Coming to issue number 6, BJP won 2 important elections of state assembly. One is in Gujarat, other is in Himachal Pradesh. So in Gujarat, let's see what is the breakup of last few years with respect to the seat allocation. 2012 election, BJP got 115 seats. Okay, while Congress got 61. In 2014, Congress got quite less number of seats. Or Congress kahin dikhai nahi. But this year, in 2017, Congress has achieved a good number. So even after losing in, you can say, Gujarat, Congress has won it. That is how it is basically being shown. And look at the percentage share. 49% people voted in favor of BJP and 42% of people voted in favor of Congress. Now this percentage share has increased tremendously compared to last 2 years. Let's see the similar figure for Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh, 2012 mein BJP lost and Congress won it. But when it came to 2014, that is basically BJP won and Congress lost. And now in 2017, once again BJP won. Now BJP won with slight margin, and if you look at the percentage share of the votes, that's also similar way. BJP has considerably won it, but number of share are decreasing. Okay, coming to the next issue, 25th edition of National Children's Science Congress. Yaad rakhega, ye Children's Science Congress hai. This is not Science Congress. Okay, Children's Science Congress was held at Gandhinagar in Gujarat. The theme was Science, Technology and Innovation for Sustainable Development, with a special focus on accessibility for the person with disability. Okay, coming to issue number 8. India voted for a negotiated settlement for Jerusalem issue at United Nations General Assembly with 127 other member countries. So India maintained a stand that there are two separate countries. One is, that is Israel, other is Palestine. So issue ye ho gaya tha that America said that Jerusalem is a part of Israel, while by two state policy Jerusalem is still with the Palestine. So India maintained their stand. United Nations resolution received 9 votes against this issue, while 127 countries were in favor of it, while 35 abstained from them. So this resolution expressed deep regret over December 7 declaration by USA President Donald Trump recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. So what is this final position? 172 out of 193 member, you can say, casted their vote. 21 countries did not vote, and out of this, 128 voted in favor, 19 against and 35 abstained. So who abstained? Possibly one of the country called Bhutan. Bhutan abstained, which may be due to their desire to demonstrate that they are independent, you can say, policy maker compared to India, as well as they do not want to antagonize. 3 important issues to be addressed before the solving this Palestine issue. Bhai dhyan rahe, Palestine ke andar ye badi pareshani hai, theek hai. Ye scenario tha kariban 1946 mein, theek hai. Ye jo green pura area hai, that is basically area captured by Arab people. Phir UN partition hua, theek hai, that is 1947 mein, aur uske dwara jo white area aaya, that is basically the area of Israel. And then 1949 se 1957 ke beech mein alag alag war karke hai na, Jewish settlement badhne lage, and this is a 2009 ka situation. Okay, this is 2009 situation. So Palestine must become sovereign and a viable state. So yeah, that is important scenario, because agar Palestine alag state nahi banta hai, so there is a problem. There is also question of refugees, that who are basically evicted during so many wars in the past, to unke liye kya kiya jayega. And another important part is Jerusalem ke liye kya karna chahiye. Agar ye teen problem solve kare jayenge to jaake shayad ye Palestine aur Jerusalem ka issue ban sakta hai. Coming to issue number 9, an agreement was signed with Switzerland. Dhyan rakhega, this is very important agreement with Switzerland, which will allow automatic sharing of tax related information from January 1, 2018. So 1st January 2018 onwards, bhaiya, Switzerland will automatically share data with India. Okay, so this is a joint declaration for the implementation of automatic exchange of information. Okay, this is very important. Dhyan rakhega, automatic exchange of information conforms to a norm set by global economic body, which is called OECD, for tax transparency. What is OECD? Organization for economic cooperation and development. Point number 10. India and Myanmar have signed an agreement for restoration of normalcy and development of Rakhine state, from where Rohingya Muslims recently fled following the incidents of violence. Rakhine is this area in Myanmar. Yera Myanmar, aur ye jo pura region hai, that is called Rakhine. Rakhine is predominantly, you can say, occupied by Muslim people. While Myanmar is not providing, Myanmar is not providing them citizens right. ठीक है, citizenship right उनको मिल नहीं रहा है. और recently ये Rakhine area में कुछ against रोहिंग्या communities ने, ठीक है, जो भी वहां की government के जो जो रोहिंग्या community है, उन लोगों ने कुछ पुलिस के ऊपर अटैक किया. After that army took a full crackdown, और उसकी वजह से बहुत सारे लोग यहां से भागकर बांग्लादेश गए, और बांग्लादेश से भी बहुत सारे लोग इंडिया में आए. And that is where the problem is happening. Okay, so ये Rakhine state के लिए एक बहुत अच्छा agreement हुआ है, which is very critical for Indian internal security. Coming to issue number 11, Airtel deposited an interim penalty of 2.5 crore with Aadhaar issuing body, which is called UIDAI. So Unique Identity Authority of India के ने Airtel के ऊपर एक केस किया था. ठीक है, क्या केस था? बेसिकली दिस टेलीकॉम ऑपरेटर हैज एलिजिबली, उन्होंने गलत तरीके से लोगों के पेमेंट बैंक के अकाउंट खोल दिए. जो भी एयरटेल का मोबाइल सब्सक्राइबर था, उनका ऑटोमेटिक अकाउंट उनकी एयरटेल पेमेंट बैंक के साथ खोल दिया, विच इज रियली नॉट ओके. उनकी परमिशन के बगैर ये खोलना, विच इज वायोलेशन ऑफ norms. So company has given assurance that it will return 190 crore that has flown into unsolicited payment bank account over, you can say, 31 lakh mobile subscriber within next 24 hours. Itna paisa wo wapas de denge. That is the important issue. Coming to issue number 12, India ki pehli national rail transportation university will come up at Vadodara. This has been approved by union cabinet. So this is to skill human resources and build capacity in our country. It is supported through UGC. It will be deemed to be university. Okay, the first academic program is going to start from July 2018. Okay, so this is in Vadodara. Yaad rakhega ye. Coming to issue number 13, World Inequality Report 2018 was released by World Inequality Lab. It said that income inequality in India increased since economic liberalization 1991 mein kiya gaya tha. So this is in contrast to earlier decades when the inequality dropped under socialist policies. Jab 1991 ke pehle government of India ki jo socialist policies thi, उस समय पे जो इनइक्वालिटी थी वो काफी कम थी, अब वो बढ़ गई. द इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट इन इनकमिंग एस्पेक्ट द इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट इज इनकम मोबिलिटी, विच रिफ्लेक्ट्स नंबर ऑफ पीपल मूविंग अप और डाउन इन द इकोनॉमिक लैडर एंड द इनकम मोबिलिटी ऑफ डाउन ट्रोडन पॉसिबल व्हेन द गवर्नमेंट टेक्स केयर ऑफ द सोशल गुड्स लाइक एजुकेशन हेल्थ केयर टू प्रोवाइड द लेवल प्लेइंग फील्ड. So this inequality reduces. Now with this, inequality improves. Number 14, very important question. 21-year-old artist from Chennai, Satvika Sridhar, she is a graduate in the visual art, is the winner of first ever UNICEF climate comic contest. Okay, this is creating a character, and which is a comic character for protecting climate change. She developed a character which is half human and half tree, ठीक है, which is named as Light. उसका नाम दिया गया Light. Okay, so this will come up with a new, you can say, comic in future. So this is contest created by UNICEF. याद रखेगा, नाम याद रखेगा ये girl का जिसका नाम है Satvika Sridhar. Coming to issue number 15, combined meeting of four task force on methanol. So methanol is one of the very important thing, because methanol has to be blended with the current petrol. Okay, methanol is cheaper and it is considered to be pollution free. And this task force meeting was headed under the chairmanship of one of the member of Niti Aayog, that is Dr. V.K. Saraswat. The task forces comprises of the experts, scientists, academicians, which took the stock of the progress in the efforts to explore and give the push to methanol economy. Remember, methanol is an emerging, clean, cheaper, safer and pollution-free energy option. It can be used for transportation as well as for the cooking fuel. India has potential to undertake production of methanol from high ash coal using indigenous technology. Remember, what is methanol? It is clear and colorless liquid. It is produced from coal or natural gases or renewable biomass, including solid waste. Existing facilities can be revamped to convert the high ash coal, which are stranded in gas and biomass, and thereby it is converted into methanol. Very important thing. Yaad rakhega ye. Coming to issue number 16. Indian Coast Guard ship Sujai. That's a 6th in the series, which is, you can say, 105 meter offshore patrol vessel, was commissioned in Indian Coast Guard at Goa. Sujai means great victory. It is a projection of Indian Coast and Coast Guards, their will and their commitment to serve and protect maritime interest of the nation. It will be based at Paradip, Odisha. Okay, so Odisha mein ye lagaya jayega. Par ye built hua tha Goa shipyard mein, aur iski wajah se uska commissioning Goa mein hua tha. Coming to issue number 17, the government stated that it has set up and operationalized 5 integrated checkpost at, which are the places? Atari, Punjab, Agartala, Tripura, Petrapol, West Bengal, Raxaul in Bihar, and Jogbani in Bihar. Okay, so this are the, so two Bihar mein, ek Tripura, ek West Bengal, ek Punjab. So government has approved setting up of ICPs. And ICP is integrated checkpost. ठीक है, so वो दूसरी और जगहों पे पहले भी थे, मोरे मणिपुर में और दाउकी इन मेघालय. The decision to put more ICPs has been taken primarily to improve the, you can say, system for, you can say, good number of trade and transportation of people. This is with a view to set up a proper system which will ensure security related activities. Moving towards number 18, government officials and gems and jewelry export promotion council representative attended Kimberley process session held at Brisbane at Australia. Yaad rahe, is bar India has been appointed as a vice chair for 2018 for this Kimberley process, and 2019 mein India will become chair. So what is this Kimberley process? Kimberley process is a joint government and international diamond industry and civil society initiative. So primarily to reduce conflict of interest. So there are conflict diamonds. There are a lot of conflict diamonds. They means rough diamonds used by the rebel movement or their allies to finance conflict aimed at undermining legitimate government. So basically diamonds used by ISIS ya koi aise conflict area ke andar कोई जो rebellion group है वो उसको use न कर सके इस purpose के लिए. So it is described as United Nations Security Council resolution. Kimberley process certification scheme came into force from 1st January 2003. It evolved an effective mechanism for stopping the trade in the conflict diamonds. India is a founding member. India was also the chair in 2008. Now India will become vice chair in 2018 and chair in 2019. Coming to number 39 countries have identified under Project Mausam, which is initiative of Ministry of Culture. So what is this Project Mausam? Project Mausam is to explore the multifaceted Indian Ocean world. It is to collect archaeological as well as historical research in order to document diverse, you can say, cultural diversity and commercial and religious interaction of India with other countries in the Indian Oceans list. The main objective is to inscribe places and sites under Project Mausam as a transnational nomination for inscription on UNESCO's World Heritage Site. The project is initiative from Ministry of Culture and implemented through Archaeological Survey of India as a nodal agency. Coming to issue number 20, 11th edition of Nasim al-Bahar, or which is also meaning called Sea Breeze, is that is an exercise which was conducted between Indian Navy and Oman Navy. This is conducted near Muscat. Okay, so yaad rakhega, Navy exercise called Nasim al-Bahar, kaun si do country ke beech mein? India and Oman. Coming to issue number 21, All India Institute of Ayurveda became operational, okay, which is under part of Ministry of Ayush. Yaad rahe, Ayush ke baare mein humne bahut baar baatein kari hai, okay. It was established in New Delhi. This Institute of Ayurveda is a 200-bedded referral hospital and it imparts postgraduate as well as PhD degree in Ayurveda. Coming to number 22, our President Ramnath Kovind inaugurated Andhra Pradesh Fiber Grid Project. This is aiming at providing affordable high-speed internet service to every household in that particular state. It aims to cover 1.45 crore household, 60,000 schools, 12,200 panchayats and 10,000 government offices through this high-speed internet. So this is one of the very important initiative by Andhra Pradesh. So yaad rakhega, fiber grid project is through Andhra Pradesh. Coming to 23, Parliament has passed a bill which is called Indian Institute of Petroleum and Energy Bill 2017. So thereby, this institute will get established at Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh as an institute of national importance. So it will focus on research and themes of petroleum, hydrocarbon and energy. So yaad rakhega ye. Coming to issue number 24, Union Ministry of Home Affairs, okay, has directed all NGOs, individuals and business entities receiving foreign funding to open accounts in any of the 32 designated, you can say, banks, including one foreign bank. So they have to put their account only and only with this designated banks. Kyun aisa ho raha hai? The purpose is to provide higher level of transparency and hassle-free reporting compliance. Taki ek jagah pe puri information ikatta ho sake aur pura process bahut smooth ho sake aur galat logo ke paise galat organization mein na ja sake aur usko protect kar sake. Coming to 25, India government Mint, IGM, which is a unit of Security Printing and Minting Corporation of India Limited. Unhone sabse pehla homegrown high purity gold reference standard develop kiya hai. This is known as Bharatiya Nirdeshak Dravya BND 4201. Yaad rakhega hai. Ab ye kya hai? Bhaiya, ek gold jo ek quality ka, the highest quality of gold, which is 99.99% pure, theek hai, wo gold hai na, unka unhone ek kya bolte hai, reference standard bana ke rakha hai. Abhi tak gold ka koi reference standard nahi hota tha, theek hai. So now this is very important. So far India is importing from Canada and Switzerland for the gold standard. Pehli bar India ka khud ka gold standard bana hua hai. Number yaad rakhega, BND 4201, and with a impurity of 99.99%. Coming to issue number 26, Dubai announced plan to become world's first blockchain powered government by 2020. By 2020, Dubai wants all visa application, bill payments and license renewal will be transacted digitally through blockchain technology. Yaad rahe, blockchain technology is basically dependent on a public ledger. Okay? So it is dependent on a public ledger and this is what they try to shift. That's a very important news. Coming to number 27, methanol and its gaseous form, that is dimethyl ether, is likely to be notified as a transport fuel soon. Humne abhi dekha tha iske bare mein jankari, that India is trying to develop methanol economy, and through that methanol will be blended in a petrol. अब उसके लिए एक approval चाहिए कि वो transport fuel है कि नहीं, उसका approval चाहिए. So India has extensive discussion with Israel, which has successfully implemented methanol 15 blending program for technology transfer. Global engine manufacturer such as Volvo, Caterpillar, Mercedes, in collaboration with certain Indian players, will be doing this kind of engine manufacturing activity in India. Coming to issue number 28, North Karnataka observed burnt in protest against non-release of Mahadayi river water. Remember, Mahadayi river water are to be shared between Goa, Maharashtra and Karnataka. Goa mein usko Mandovi river bolte hain, aur uska jo pani release nahi karna tha, uski wajah se ek protest hua tha, ek din ka pura band rakha gaya tha. Issue number 29, India's first pod taxi is expected to come up between Delhi and Gurgaon. Gurgaon is called Gurugram now, over a length of 12.3 km on public-private partnership basis. So this will be taken on design, build, finance, operate and transfer basis. So company design karegi, build karegi, usko finance kahin se aayega, ya wo khud finance karegi, phir operate karegi usko, wahan se paise kamayegi, and then it will transfer to government. Okay, so this will come at, you can say, this Delhi Gurgaon region. Pod taxi, ek tarike ki, matlab kam logo ko le jane wali high speed, you can say, technique hai. This is very important. China will maintain communication with India on efforts to manage massive lakes formed by landslips on Brahmaputra in Tibet. So China ne India ke saath communication maintain karke rakha hai, that jo abhi Brahmaputra region mein bahut jyada landslips ho gayi, uske wajah se bade bade lake create ho gaye. This three artificial huge lakes were formed in Brahmaputra. It is known as Yalung Sangpo due to landslips which occurred due to earthquake in Tibet. The massive accumulation of water has caused concerns that the lakes merge or overflows, and millions of people downstream of this Brahmaputra, which is at Arunachal Pradesh and Assam, they would be affected. China stated that it will provide the right information on the huge artificial water bodies formed along Brahmaputra due to such kind of earthquake. Coming to issue number 31, first ever broad gauge air condition AC IMU, which is a suburban train, was inaugurated at Western Railway, Mumbai. So broad gauge IMU was first time developed. Okay, so it is India ka pehla first AC IMU, that is local jo train hai Mumbai ki, which is called IMU, jo AC nahi hai. So this is first AC is getting developed there. Coming to issue number 32, good governance day every year is celebrated on 25th December. This is a birthday of former Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee. On this occasion, government launched EHRMS, which is called Human Resource Management System. It will provide HR analytics to government. Yaad rakhne ki do cheeze, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, former Prime Minister of India, unki birth anniversary 25th December, aur usi din celebrate kiya jata hai Good Governance Day. Coming to 33, the team of Indian Air Force completed Mission 7 Summit. So with the successful ascent of Mount Vinson, yaad rahe, humne last month mein baat kari thi ki ye Mount Vinson jo Antarctica mein aaya hai, usko ye achieve karenge, to Indian Air Force will become the first Indian organization to successfully climb all 7 summits of the world. So which are the 7 summits? Bhai, sabse pehla Mount Everest, jo matlab Asia mein hai, जो यूरोप में है माउंट एल्ब्रूस, अफ्रीका में है माउंट किलिमंजारो, ठीक है, देन यू हैव नॉर्थ अमेरिका में माउंट मैकेनली, ठीक है, एंड देन यू हैव इन साउथ अमेरिका, ठीक है, व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एकनकागुआ, एंड ये है आपका माउंट विंसन, और ये आपके यू कैन से ऑस्ट्रेलिया में है, व्हिच इज कॉल्ड यू कैन से माउंट यू कैन से पिनरुकजिया. सो दिस आर द 7 समिट जो इंडियन एयरफोर्स ने अचीव किया है आफ्टर माउंट विंसन. ओके, दैट्स अ वेरी गुड न्यूज. Coming to issue number 35, so issue number 34, China's homegrown AG-600, which is world's largest amphibious aircraft. Amphibious, which means zameen pe bhi chalega aur pani pe bhi chalega. It is capable of carrying 50 people. Okay? And it can go airborne for 12 hours. So it will make China as among world's few countries which are capable of developing their own amphibious aircraft. So this is AG-600. Okay? Yaad rakhega ye. Shashastra Bhima Dal. Shashastra Bhima Bal celebrated their 54th anniversary. Uska inception hua tha 1963 mein. Okay, on 20th December. Okay, that is, you can say, second largest border guarding force in the country. So this is coming under Ministry of Home Affairs. It is responsible for guarding Indo-Nepal border as well as Bhutan border. Coming to issue number 36, a record-breaking snowfall more than 60 inches hit the Pennsylvania city of Erie over the Christmas period. So city declared emergency. It matlab samajh sakte hai 60 inch ka barf girna, that's a huge, that's a big problem. Number 37, government proposed hiking the salary and the pension of judges through a bill called High Court and Supreme Court Judges Salaries and Condition of Service Amendment Bill 2017. Salaries of judges and judges of Supreme Court and High Court will be, you can say, affected by this. Last, it was revised in 2006. Okay, and this is 7th Pay Commission ke recommendation ke dwara ye changes kiye gaye hai. So what are the changes? By past salary kya thi unki? 1 lakh. And now what is the salary? 2.80 lakhs. That is how the per month salary of Chief Justice of India, Supreme Court judges ki salary 90,000. Okay, thi pehle, abhi 2.5 lakh. Chief Justice of High Court 2.5 lakh. And High Court ki judges ki salary abhi 2.25 lakh. Okay. So that is how it is being proposed. Coming to issue number 38, Manipur Central University, Imphal will host 105th session of Indian Science Congress. Yaad rahe, Indian Children's Science Congress was held at Gandhinagar, Gujarat, and this is being held at, you can say, Imphal, that is in Manipur. So the decision was taken at the emergency meeting of Indian Science Congress held at Kolkata. The session was to be held Hyderabad during 3rd January to 7th January, but it was postponed due to security issues, and thereby now it will be held at Manipur, Imphal. Coming to issue number 39, Vidarbha clinched first maiden Ranji Trophy in their 84th season. By 84th season thi Ranji ki, jisme inhone bahut bar participate kiya tha. They couldn't win it and they won it for the first time. Remember, PTM was a sponsor for that. So PTM Ranji Trophy. Aur usme jeeta kaun? You can say Vidarbha. Theek hai? So dekhe bhaiya, sabse zyada kaun jeeta hai? Hai na? Bhai, six other teams have won this trophy. Gujarat, Haryana, you can say Navanagar, inhone, aur Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, aur Western India, inhone ek ek bar jeeti hai. Sabse zyada bar Mumbai, number 2 Karnataka, and so and so forth. So is tarike se alag alag teamon ne jeeta hai. Is bar pehli bar Vidarbha ne ye jeeta hai. Coming to issue number 40, Ganga Gram project was launched to make 4,470 Ganga villages swach and fully developed. This was launched at Vigyan Bhavan in Delhi. This is a project for sanitation based on integrated development of all 4,470 villages along river Ganga. Okay, so what is this Ganga Gram project? Ganga Gram is an integrated approach for holistic development of villages situated on the bank of river Ganga. Okay, this is what they are trying to develop for sanitation purpose and giving drinking water. Karnataka government unveiled a brand logo of Bangalore. Here are Bangalore ka logo. For the first time in our country, the city, first city to get their own logo called Bangalore. With this, Bangalore city joins New York, Melbourne, Singapore and other global cities to have their own tourism logo. The logo called BU, which is a mixed of typography of English and Kannada. Aap dekh sakte, BU is written in English aur baki sab cheeze aapko Kannada mein likha gaya hai. 18th meeting of Financial Stability and Development Council FSDC was held under chairmanship of Union Minister of Finance Shri Arun Jaitley. Okay, this is very important because financial stability ke liye desh ko kya kya karna chahiye uske bare mein meeting hoti hai, aur ye meeting में कौन पार्टिसिपेट किए थे? गवर्नर ऑफ आरबीआई, फाइनेंस सेक्रेटरी, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक अफेयर, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट अफेयर, चीफ इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजर, हु इज द चीफ इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजर ऑफ इंडिया, श्री अरविंद सुब्रमण्यम, चेयरमैन ऑफ IRDAI, IRDAI, चेयरमैन ऑफ सेबी एंड चेयरमैन ऑफ फ्यू अदर रेगुलेटरी बॉडी. कमिंग टू इश्यू नंबर 43, यूनियन मिनिस्टर फॉर वाटर रिसोर्सेज श्री नितिन गडकरी लेड द फाउंडेशन स्टोन टू प्रोटेक्ट द वर्क ऑफ मजुली आइलैंड प्राइमरली टू प्रोटेक्ट इट फ्रॉम द फ्लड एंड इरोजन इन आसाम. रिमेंबर मजुली आइलैंड इज सराउंडेड बाई माइटी ब्रह्मपुत्र रिवर. सो वो ब्रह्मपुत्र रिवर के अंदर दिस इज अ मजुली आइलैंड विच इज द लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग आइलैंड इन द वर्ल्ड. सो दिस इज उसको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए ये बिल्कुल प्रोग्राम किया गया है. भाई ये आपकी मतलब ये जो आपकी ब्रह्मपुत्र रिवर है वो यहाँ से अरुणाचल प्रदेश में से एंटर होती है और फिर वो आसाम जाती है, आसाम से जाकर सीधी जाती है बांग्लादेश और यहाँ कहीं बीच में है मजुली आइलैंड. मजुली आइलैंड है रिवर में आया हुआ ऐसा एक मजेदार सा आइलैंड विच इज अ फ्लोटिंग आइलैंड, वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग आइलैंड. उसको बचाने के लिए, उसको प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए ये अलग से फंडिंग लगाई गई है. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस रिलीज देयर अचीवमेंट फॉर द ईयर ऑफ 2017. क्या क्या अचीवमेंट हुए हैं उनके? सबसे पहला अचीवमेंट उन्होंने बताया है, ये एग्जाम में पूछा जा सकता है, ठीक है, मूडी ने जो रेटिंग दी है इंडिया की, जो पहले BAA3 थी जो अभी BAA2 कर दी, विच इज अ गुड, इंडिया की डेवलपमेंट अच्छी हुई. इंडिया मूव्स 30 रैंक इन वर्ल्ड बैंक्स ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस. ठीक है, पहले इंडिया का रैंक 130 था, वो अभी हो गया 100. इन्होंने 1 जुलाई, ठीक है, 2017 से GST इंट्रोड्यूस किया. रिकैपिटलाइजेशन ऑफ पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स, कितना पैसा? 2.11 लाख करोड़, ठीक है, इतना पैसा बैंक ने लगाया. भारत 22 एक्सचेंज ट्रेडेड फंड इंट्रोड्यूस किया गया एंड मैकेनिज्म बाय गिविंग मोर पावर टू RBI टू सॉल्व बैड लोन प्रॉब्लम इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस. ये सभी पॉइंट्स को दो बार रिवाइज करिएगा बिकॉज इसमें से एक सवाल आना पक्का है. कमिंग टू इश्यू नंबर 45, ठीक है, इसको भी दो बार रिवाइज करिएगा. वेरियस मिलिट्री एक्साइज का एक रिकॉर्ड बना के दिया है यहाँ पे, इंडो ओमान मिलिट्री एक्साइज कॉल्ड अल नागा, ओमान और इंडिया के बीच में मिलिट्री एक्साइज इज अल नागा. ध्यान रहे सी ब्रीज इज अ नेवी एक्सरसाइज. इंडो नेपाल सूर्य किरण, इंडो मोगोलियन नॉमेडिक एलिफेंट, इंडो US युद्ध अभ्यास, इंडो श्रीलंका मित्र शक्ति, इंडो रशिया इंद्र, इंडो कजाकिस्तान प्रबल दोस्तिक, इंडो बांग्लादेश संप्रीति, इंडो UK अजय वॉरियर. ये सब एक कंपाइलेशन आपके लिए, प्लीज उसको आप याद रखिएगा, बहुत जरूरी है. नंबर 46, बॉक्सिंग डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन 26 December एवरी ईयर. ऑन दिस डे पीपल गेट रिलैक्स्ड, यू कैन से विदाउट एनी काइंड ऑफ वरीज. दिस इज वेयर दे गेट अ चांस, यू कैन से टू लुक बैक एट द फेस्टिव सीजन एंड बी हैप्पी. इट इज बिटवीन क्रिसमस एंड न्यू ईयर एंड मेनी पीपल यूटिलाइज दिस फॉर देयर न्यू ईयर रेजोल्यूशन. सो बॉक्सिंग डे इज December 26. प्राइम मिनिस्टर इनॉग्रेटेड अ न्यू स्ट्रेच, दैट इज अ न्यू मैजेंटा लाइन इन दिल्ली मेट्रो. दिल्ली मेट्रो में मैजेंटा लाइन विच इज बोटानिकल गार्डन इन नोएडा टू कालकाजी मंदिर इन दिल्ली, इसके बीच में ये बनाई गई है. दिस इज यू कैन से थर्ड मेट्रो लाइन विच इज इनॉग्रेटेड बाय यू कैन से प्राइम मिनिस्टर. भाई दो जगह पे इलेक्शन हुए थे अभी हमने देखा, गुजरात एंड हिमाचल प्रदेश. सो कौन नए चीफ मिनिस्टर बने? मिस्टर विजय रूपानी इज अ चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ गुजरात एंड नितिन पटेल इज चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ डेप्यूटी चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ गुजरात वाइल मिस्टर जयराम ठाकुर बिकेम द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश. कमिंग टू इश्यू नंबर 49, दिस इज तमिल सुपरस्टार रजनीकांत अनाउंस्ड हिज अराइवल इन द पॉलिटिक्स. ही डिक्लेयर्ड दैट ही विल लॉन्च हिज पॉलिटिकल पार्टी टू कंटेस्ट ऑल 234 कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसीज इन तमिलनाडु. द टर्म ऑफ तमिलनाडु असेंबली विल एंड बाय 2021 एंड द लोकसभा इलेक्शंस आर ड्यू इन 2019. तो उस समय पे रजनीकांत का इन्वॉल्वमेंट वुड टर्न आउट टू बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो विद दिस वी क्लोज दिस लास्ट मॉड्यूल ऑफ डिसम्बर. वी फील दैट यू आर एंजॉइंग दिस you can say videos, and a lot of you are asking a lot of questions which you have query about your CLAT preparation. We are more than happy to answer all your queries, all your problems will be sorted out. Okay, so keep writing all your queries, keep suggesting us few things, and more importantly, keep giving us good rating, and do not forget to subscribe us. Thank you very much.